If you like this video, please like, share, and subscribe. Hey everyone, Malkadrian here, and I'm here to show you The Last Word. This game's been out for a while now, but I feel like I still really want to show this off, because the main mechanic for this game is very nice. Very nice indeed. Though we won't be seeing the main mechanic for a little while, considering the fact that, well, we have an intro cutscene. Excuse me, gentlemen. This is the estate of Professor Chatters, is it not?
Indeed. We've just arrived as well.
The servant should be back out soon, milady. He'll see to letting you in. Don't wait up for us. I didn't expect to see this already. See what? This chit-chat. War of the words. You know, what those two fellows are engaging in right now.
After you. I insist.
All I see is a bit of discourse. Wordplay is common enough at social gatherings, if not entirely expected. Yes, but have you ever met Judge Boasting and Mr. McCall? I'm familiar with them, but we've never been formally introduced. Why? They continuously attempt to get the last word on each other. It's a pain to listen to. It's as if whoever speaks last gets a big prize or some such thing. That's exactly the point, young sir. Try not to play ignorant. This is a rather large estate. Only the best for Professor Chatters. Care to come inside? What of the other two? If we wait for them, we'll be out here all evening, freezing our smiles off. Come along. He shut the door on us, and after inviting us in. Can you believe the nerve? Oddly enough, I can. Hopefully the exceptional Professor Chatters will have a bit more manners. You have never met him either? I can't say that I have, but I couldn't refuse his invitation. This should be a fairly high-profile gathering, if I'm not mistaken. It'll be a great boost for my position in the Messenbow Corporation.
It's due time we entertained our host, Mr. McCall. After you.
Very grateful of you, Mr. Boasting, but I insist you lead the way.
I couldn't possibly, Mr. McCall.
Mr. Boasting, you simply must allow me the pleasure of letting you go first. I insist.
But surely...
See what I mean? You are a bit ignorant, aren't you? I'm Winnie Gossip. A pleasure to meet you. I'm Seymour Seymour of Seymour House. A pleasure. What do you say we get inside before it gets much darker?
And now we have hospitality. He who scoffs last, scoffs best. Now we're in the house proper. And this is where we'll be... Basically, this is the entire playing area. This entirety of this house. So, get to exploring. Get to checking stuff out. Because most of the time, you're going to want to... Well, you're going to want to discover everything so that you've basically 100% of the game. And it is somewhat easy to 100% this game, in my opinion anyways. Because, well, not everything is about losing into the game over. Because there is no such thing as a game over in this game. So, this is Summerhouse, the estate of Professor Chatters. Of course. Why state the obvious? Should it be obvious? I've never stepped foot in here before. Good point. You certainly haven't. I don't just let anyone enter onto the property. Okay. You're a bit judgmental for a servant. Possibly. Professor Chatters has a strict guideline for who can and not attend his little get-togethers. There are multitudes of dowdy figures vying to tumble through that front door. Sometimes his guests have class. Other times I must bite my tongue, like now, for example. I don't suppose you worked here long with an attitude like that. I'm a professional, Mr. Seymour. I've been here quite some time, and I never forget a frumpy face. I'll be sure to add you both to my mental catalog of regular attendees. The others are up this way. Follow me. Are you ready? I suppose. This isn't exactly my forte. No? You don't mingle often? My mother handled most of these engagements. Key topics. Oh yes, this is another mechanic. Key topics are things that you would learn from people, and basically you can level them up to a maximum of 5. One has a maximum of 6, but I'll tell you, well, actually I'm not going to tell you about that, but just keep in mind that there is one that has a level 6. She was the head of the Seymour house. I was a bit sheltered myself. Maybe you'll pick up on some of her skills? I can only hope. I'll meet you by wherever the alcohol floweth freeeth. And we have movement. Shows you the instructions, and you don't need to do anything else except the... You don't need to know anything else except the enter key, because I could... You know, examine this. Looks like it's a transparent bottle tucked far behind the glass. And seeing as that's a topic I don't know of, I can't interact with it fully.
Yeah.
Tonight promises to be interesting. Quite a few new faces. Myself included. Most certainly, you especially. And it's bothersome. I come to these parties for some real conversation, discussions, arguments, gossip. Honestly, Miss Gossip, Witty Gossip, I know who you are. I'm being condescending. But as I was saying, Miss Gossip, was it? Condescending my foot. More like you're being an idiot. Ignorant. I don't think you have what it takes to hold your own here. You're serious? I am. Do you disagree? I most certainly do. Excellent. And, well, as the instructions say, move the conversation cursor, which is that flickering thing right there, forward to get the last word. And as you can see, there's lose and win. We lose, we lose. And, well, something will happen if we lose. Well, something negative, though not exactly horrible, mind you. Higher levels have greater starting advantage. Witty is 11 levels lower, as you can see. Okay, well, let's go with subtle. Push that conversation bar over. And I lose. At least you lost gracefully. Yes, the first battle, the first discourse that you ever have, you're going to lose. No. You're going to lose incredibly. Mainly because she, well, is 12 levels higher. Well, it seems I've left you speechless. Be a good girl and bring me a glass of that 20-year Blanc. It's just delicious. Come now, show me some class. Don't leave a thirsty woman waiting her evening nip. You can pour a glass of wine fairly well. At least, I commend you. Classy slip that is in no way obnoxious. Simply divine. As you're no doubt aware, there's great power in the ability to get the last word in a conversation. In that brief moment of speechlessness, you are susceptible to my persuasive persuasions. It's a positively overwhelming feeling. It certainly is. You don't sound enthusiastic enough, and it bores me to no end. If you'll excuse me, I'm going to strike up a conversation elsewhere.
Find the lock icon to progress the story.
Yeah, to which we will not be progressing the story, mainly because... Well, actually, we will be progressing it slightly because, well, in order to actually get into the to knowing the entire gameplay proper, we have to get into some actual discourse, not that faux discourse where it tells you that if you lose, you are susceptible to commands. And that means you could be, honestly, susceptible to pretty much anything. As far as I know. Now, mind you, that could be completely, totally wrong. Like, there is some certain limitation to the power of the last word, but... often enough, it's... well... you know that. I'm a little surprised seeing you talk with Mrs. Prano like that. You mean just now? What of it? It's just... I don't know, it's like watching a fight. I didn't expect you to take part in it. We've just met Seymour. I don't know why you're already making expectations. You're alright. I guess I'm still a little bit flustered. Like I said before, my mother usually handled these affairs. Looks like I have a lot to learn. Well, let's teach him the basics. Which means we go into the... discourse already. Common discourse can be summed up by saying that whoever gets the last word wins. As you can see, disruptive is power, submissive increases... let me rephrase that. Disruptive increases your power, which is that power bar up there. Submissive increases tact, which increases the bottom bar right there. And aggressive is that bar on the bottom. To move the conversation forward, you need to carefully juggle three types of phrases. We'll be simple. Let's start with the disruptive phrase. And disruptive, well, allows you to generate... let me rephrase that. Some disruptive abilities allow you to use to push the conversation bar over, whereas all of them increase powers. Say, for example, I want to be overt. I can do that, and that will increase my, well, power primarily, or it can be common, and increase my power a little bit, and push the bar to the win side in a little bit. This disruptive phrase garnered a small amount of power in the conversation. To really affect the discourse, we need tact. Now that we have some power, select the submissive phrase. But first, we'll give the opposition their turn. As you can see, Seymour did number one, which is this one, the subtle one. There is subtle, common, and overt. Now for submissive. As you can see, we have subtle, common, and overt. And actually, just the thing that you should know, you see those shapes? You'll get what that is all about in a moment. But first, let's gain some tact. And as you can see, Seymour is a little irritated. That's because I did a little game called Rock, Paper, Scissors. I call it Rock, Paper, Scissors because, well, as you can see, square beats circle, star beats square, and circle beats star. And it's a good thing, and it's a good idea to actually break their composure, as they call it, in order to give yourself a stronger push every time you use one of the aggressive abilities. Because, as you can see, it pushes it by composure plus a number. Say, for example, Seymour is, you know, he has one composure loss. That means I get 1 plus 3, which equals 4. Although it does cost tact in order to actually use that ability. The more panics shown over composure, the more conversation moves forward when using aggressive phrases. Composure is important. If someone has damaged composure, they become more susceptible to aggressive phrases. Or to be more clear, aggressive phrases move the conversation further if the listener has a worse composure. And as you can see, the tone wheel, which is basically like rock, paper, scissors. I've already talked about that. And mind you, you have composure as well, so if you lose composure and they use aggressive, that means you're going to be going towards the lose side. Let's see, square, so I want to go with circle. I don't have circles, so I want to go with, not that one, I will go with this one. No, wait, wrong one, I was supposed to be going with star. Sometimes I goof up like that. Let's see, now I need to go square. Now I need to go square. And he's boosting his tact. Let's see, star, I need circle. Do I have enough tact? No, no. Yes, I have enough tact. Yes, each way of attack, like disruptive, submissive, and aggressive, are all different, because disruptive has this for their circle, square, and star, whereas aggressive has star, circle, square. So keep an eye out for that. All right, let's beat Master Seymour. Say more. You won! Cheers! Now, mind you, we were basically having a one-on-one, level one-on-one. We gain experience after discourse. XP is higher when winning than losing. Yes, losing means, well, you don't lose completely. You still get experience out of it. And mind you, experience acquired is stored into the stored experience, which is that little cash sign right there, which is actually useful for buying skills. Skills is something I will not be able to cover in this video, but let me tell you, skills really do have a very, very good amount of benefits to it. And there is actually a number of ways, well actually there's another way to get a stored EXP, which is by interacting with stuff in the house. Now, mind you, you need topics in order to actually activate some of them, but mind you, you can do that. Feel smarter? I suppose. Just try to remember the phrase, civilitas civilitatum. Is St. Lawton's motto? I've never learned Latin. It's not Latin. It's complete gibberish to the finest degree, but everything has meaning. It works as a reminder that in the civilized world, it isn't what you say that matters, but how you say it. Civilitas civilitatum. Civilitatum. Our nation hasn't steered us wrong yet. I'll try to keep that in mind. Perhaps I'll start picking up on some of the finer points as I go along.
And so I told the young lady that she could have my hat only if she put down the revolver.
Brilliant tale, Mr. Boasting. I'm sure that impoverished child you save will never forget your deeds.
He better not. Servant, when are we going to meet the professor?
At breakneck speed, I assure you. Professor Chatters needs to finish setting up the equipment before the grand display.
And we get newest invention.
And let's say you tell us what this new device of us is, eh?
I've been sworn to secrecy, as I'm sure you'd expect, Judge Boasting, but your charm is noted. I encourage you all to mingle while we wait. The wine is out and corked. Enjoy it.
It looks like we must wait a little bit longer, Mr. McCall.
It seems to be that way, Mr. Boasting. Care to grab a drink?
I'd love to, Mr. McCall. After you.
This is a small party. I expected a more varied crowd, don't you? I guess I never thought about it, but maybe more people will arrive. The night's young.
Key topics. Select the key topic and gossip with the guests.
Yep, level up the topic to learn new ones.
And as you can see, there's a lot of key topics, as you can see. And all the other things we have right now is... I think there's a bug. because it should be highlighting the right circles. It's probably a glitch. They must have messed something up by accident. But no worries, the topics are still there. Samer House, newest invention, they just won't be in the same circles, mind you. Anyways, before I finish up, I need to let you know that those skills that I told you guys about, they require things called bows. As you can see, she has no bows on her. And in order to use skills, you need bows. How do you get bows? Well, by leveling up is one, and another is actually beating all these people in discourse. As well as, I think everyone in here, and leveling up. I think there was something else as well. I don't remember what, though. No, those were the only ones. Leveling up and beating everyone in here in discourse. Yeah, so long as it's not the story-driven one. Because when you interact with someone when they have their lock on them, that means it's going to progress the story. And it's best to take care of everything in the area before progressing the story, because you might miss out on something. I'm serious about this. You might miss out on something. It's like the area will literally change. So whatever happens in Chapter 1 stays in Chapter 1, and anything that you missed in it is gone forever. Most of it, anyways. Some things will still be there, but other things will be gone. Anyways, that's it for my look at of Last Word. This is a very nice game, and I recommend you guys check it out. If this is something to your liking, I recommend, you know, getting it. But for those who probably aren't interested in this, hey, at least you know that this game exists. So until next time, this is Melkadrian, and this is The Last Word. I'll see you guys next time. Have a great day, and happy gaming.